Hello, everybody, and welcome back to my adventures in Skyrim. I have decided to record my quests from the main storyline. I know I was thinking about not recording them because people have probably seen them before, but I figure why not? It's my adventures, you probably would want to see them. And hey, if you don't want to see them, then, you know, that's the beautiful thing about videos. You can just choose to skip it if you want. So, anyway, I've also decided to make all of my followers... What are they called? Like, in the natural state, they can't die. What's that called? They had a term for it. I can't remember.
Fine. What?
Oops, that's the wrong thing.
And what might you...
Maybe it's in here. There it is. They're important. Important. So, when a character is important, they can't die. So, in this Adventures of Skyrim, I have a mod called Bury the Dead where you... It's like a spell, and you probably will see it. It's when there's a dead character, you cast a spell on them, and the character disappears, and a tombstone with their name appears. It's really cool, and, I installed that, so I'm going to... change that, so that should make them... Yep, see, now it says everyone dies, meaning right now Janasa is expendable. If she gets low enough to die, she'll die. So I decided that should make this playthrough probably a bit better. And so right now, I'm going to... Oh, I guess it does it for everybody. Oh, wow, I thought you had to pick them each individually. Well, I mean, that's fine, because I'm going to change them all to everyone dies, but... I'm glad that just, you know, makes everybody expendable. So I'm going to keep Serwadin here. Oh, she's already halted here. Are you as well? No.
Let's go.
I'll just be here then.
Who do I want to take with me? I'm going to take two people.
What do you want?
I'm still here.
I think I want you to wait here. And then Janasa will come with me. Yeah.
I am the shadow at your back.
All right, so now everybody is expendable. So, it's going to suck when they die, but with the Tundra Defense mod, I can just hire guards if I'm really needed. And plus, there's tons of NPCs in this game, just, you know, in the vanilla game. So, I mean, if a couple die here and there, it's nothing that crazy. Oh my god, you know, I just forgot. I got that water well message. I should have checked that before I left. Alright, activate water well, view latest messages, scrolls added. Let's check it out. Outpost scroll. A cousin of mine has the privilege of working at your outpost as a guard. I must be an orc then, because I only have one guard. When he came to visit me recently, he mentioned that you are looking for sponsors. I've got an extra set of lab materials and an enchanter that I'd be willing to part with if you could put a good word in with your citizens about my store, Elgrim's Elixirs. I'm pretty sure that's in Riften, right? Yeah. Okay. So we can get an enchanting station from there if we go back to Riften, which I'll do... I mean, I could do now, I could just fast travel, but I want to, you know, start the story. So we're going to go to Bleak Falls Barrow. The closest point I have is Riverwood, so that's where we're going to go. I love this Roman armor. I love that we're all just decked out. Anyway, I really like it. I probably talked about that in the last video. So there's Finn, he's all angry at me. See? Yeah. He's mad because I was on Findel's side instead of his. Also with this UFO mod, the follower mod, I'm pretty sure there's a way that you can give all of your followers horses. In fact, let me how would I do that? Would that be in magic? Does it just like... No, I don't have any spells. There's Bury the Dead. I should probably favorite that right now. Because we may have to actually use it. I know there's a way to get horses. I'll have to look it up. So that all of you and your companions can just roll around Skyrim on horses. It's pretty cool. At least I hope that's in this mod. If not, then that must be a different one. Hello, birds. Alright, on our way up to Bleak Falls Barrow. borrow a cup of sugar? Ha ha! Oh, that was dumb as hell. Alright, so there should be a wolf up here, if I remember correctly. Maybe two? I see ya. I will wear the brunt of his attack while my allies kill him. Plus, this is leveling up my block, which is something that I want. Nice. And you know what? I forgot to change the difficulty setting. Right now we're on expert. Let's do... So there's legendary. Okay, I'm going to do master instead of legendary since my people can die now. I guess you can call me a coward for not playing on legendary. I feel bad for playing on expert thus far. But here we go. We're on master. My people can die, which is probably going to happen a lot. I forgot to skin that wolf, but oh well, whatever. And normally I don't play in third person. I just love to look at the Roman armor. I don't know. I'm just really into Roman stuff, I guess. Especially right now with Rome 2 out. It's just, I got the Rome fever. Alright, so there should be a few bandits up here, I believe. Love this Flora mod, man. Really makes Skyrim look so much better. Alright, bandits. The Romans are here to kill all of you. Come get some. You wanna swing? Oh, blocked! I probably need to quick save at some point too. I'll quick save after this fight. Get him, Janessa! Get him! Yeah! Tear him to pieces. Oh man, this guy is... Oh! Fell down. That guy fell down. Alright. Let's go around here. Woo! Shield bash for the win. Alright, let's search. I need to get my carry weight down, man. Alright, let me talk to, Janessa. I need to trade some things with you there.
If that is what you wish.
Ooh, actually, she may get the heavy armor. I don't want her to. Is there anything else I can give her? That kind of doesn't weigh anything. The reason why I want to keep these is because I just want to sell them. I'm afraid that she'll wear the heavy armor, though. She won't! Oh, cool. Okay. So that UFO mod probably makes it so that they prioritize whatever skill is highest. That's cool. In the vanilla, I'm pretty sure they would just wear, like, the heaviest armor you give them, as well as whatever had the highest damage weapon, even though it doesn't match their stats. So cool, I can just give you all this stuff. You can be my pack horse for a while. Weapons, oh man. There we go. Yep. Give her some gladiuses, broadsword. I should have sold. Oh, dude, yeah, the pilum. That's part of this armor mod, or this Roman armor and weapons mod. Hold on.
Let's go.
Oh wait, you're gonna use a shield? No. Shoot.
If that is what you wish.
You cannot use a shield. I'll take that back. You'll do. Oh god.
Yes. So
Oh, I forgot.
If
I gave
that
you
is
this
what
too.
You wish.
Okay. You have no more shields, right? Okay. Anyway, let me show you the pilum. Does a ton of damage, and you throw it, but I think it. Oh, can you just pick it up? That's weird. I tested it before, and I was able to throw it, and it threw the projectile, but it laid a copy of it at my feet to pick up again. Oh, crap, and I can't pick up the projectile. I just wasted that pilum. No! Because they do a lot of damage. I don't know if you saw it, but, like, look at that. 221. My, look at that. 34. All right, well, hopefully you can craft these. I'm pretty sure they would let you craft them. I want to test it. I want to just, like, one-shot KO one of these NPCs up here. So cool they got a Pelum in this game. Ah, Bleak Falls, Borrow. How many times have I cleared your halls in my mini playthroughs? So many. Alright, let me quick save here. Because I don't want to have to redo everything we've done thus far. Now, don't worry. If I lose a companion, I'm not going to, like, revert to an old save to try to get them back. If they die, they're dead. Oh, I missed! Oh, I missed! Okay, we need to get a sword out. Here we go. And also, let me give my allies the attack order. So now they do more damage. Get him, Janasa. She's so cool. I really hope she doesn't die. Ooh! The problem with that attack order is that it does decrease their defenses by 25% or 15, something like that. All right, let's go inside. I love rolling with Romans. Rolling with Romans, you know, that should be like a web series. Quirky little opening song. Da-da-da-da-da. Rolling with the Romans. You can do it like Cops or something, you know? I don't know if any of you know what the show Cops is, but... Nice. I'm trying to tank for my followers. That's the kind of build I'm going for right now. A lot of stamina, so I can block a lot. And then, going up the block and heavy armor shield trees. Alright, so I'm regenerating health. Let's, whatever. I don't really care what's in that chest. Take that weapon. Rolling with the Romans. Or I guess it could be like a family comedy show. You know, like Friends or something. I mean, there's hundreds of family comedy shows, you know, take your pick. So it just like follows a group of, what do they call a group of... Is it like a cohort? No, not a cohort. Like, it's a smaller group. It's, it was in that Rome 2 video they released before the, like a week before the game came out. It was like a group of 8 Romans together. What were they called? Boom shaka. So yeah, it's going to be probably easy in Bleak Falls Borrow. I don't expect any of us to die, and you may think it's too easy with 2 people, but if you've played this game, you know it gets a lot harder. Okay, what is this? I used to know, like, all of these puzzles by heart. I mean, I guess I could just look over. I think you just activate each one once. Is that what it was? Snake whale. No, I was way off. There we go. I'll have to see if I remember the combination to the door at the end of this. It has been a while since I've played. Oh shit. We got skeevers coming in. Alright, come get some skeevers. Boom! What the... What the hell? He's going into the wall. What the truck? Whoa, camera freaking out. Nice. Oh, shit. Whoa. Like I said, I never really played in third person, so...
You would dare to trespass in these ruins, but you lack in wisdom. You make up for in courage.
Thank you, Janessa. Scroll of Fireball, that's good to sell. I don't ever really use the scrolls, I generally always sell them. Alright. So we got a spider fight up here. Hello. No, I've been poisoned. Oh shit. Oh, that poison. Oh my. Oh no. Oh man. That poison damage. Brutal, dude. I should have quicksaved before we got in there. I wonder if anyone tries to play this game, you know, like in an Iron Man mode, where if they die, they just restart the game. That would suck. Especially playing at this kind of difficulty. Alright, let's try to rush through this. I was worried about that poison damage. It sucks, he got me on the first flipping hit. I don't think I have any cure poison potions on me. Yeah. I should probably favorite those. So with the Skyrim Redone mod, wearing heavy armor really slows you down and really takes a lot of your stamina when you run. And light armor is noticeably a lot faster. It's really cool, the differences in Skyrim Redone. Like, I couldn't even imagine playing vanilla Skyrim anymore. Redone is just like that cool. Alright. So we got boom, 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 boom.
There may be no enemy more foul than a walking corpse.
We got the Skeever attack again. Shield bash for the win. Alright. Grab the scroll. Remember to quick save before this fight. I need to let my stamina regenerate. Very important. Alright. There we go. We meet again, Spider. Jesus. No, don't kill my people. Don't kill my people. Romans. Victorious again. Actually, technically it's Romans 1, Spider 1, because he did kill me. Hey, what up, dude?
Over here. You did it. You killed it. Now cut me down before anything else shows up. Yes, the claw. I know how it works. The claw, the markings, the door in the Hall of Stories. I know how they all fit together. Help me down and I'll show you. You won't believe the power the Nords have hidden there.
Oh, I think I have a clue.
Sweet breath of arcade. It's coming loose.
So this guy tries to run for it, so I'm just gonna kill him now. It's annoying to run after him. He's like, yeah, thanks for setting me free. Now I'm just going to try to run away. So now we press on into Bleak Falls Borough. And the undead portion. Yeah, I don't need the Fendel. So I just tried to issue an attack order, but I can only do it every 10 minutes. Apparently. Fight well, Fendel. I'll aid you, my friend. There we go. Where'd Janasa go? Just sitting in the back, taking it easy. Oh, crap. You know what? There's a mod where your allies can't trigger traps. I think that's built into the UFO mod. That's apparently not built into the UFO mod. It's very odd that they did not die, though. Oh my god. I need to go get that mod. Don't! This is so odd. They should be dying. Maybe. Alright, you know what? I'll let you catch up, Janasa. Huh. So they must have already been on the option where they die, because that should be killing them. Well, it's a good thing I changed it, because your people getting killed by traps is very crappy, because they don't know how to, you know, just walk around them. So I'll have to download that mod where they don't trigger traps, and then change the settings again to be killable. I really thought they were. Oops. There we go. That was pretty funny just to watch you get hit over and over again, though. Oh! Killing move. That shield bash.
I'll see you in pieces.
Goodbye. I guess I could check to see if they have money on them. Did not really need the axe, but I can sell that, I guess. Hello. Welcome back to the land of living. Now die. Scroll of Reeve. Lowers the health of creatures and people in the area by 52 for 40 seconds. All targets take 152 damage when one dies. Whoa. That must be one of those new spells in the Apocalypse spell package. That sounds awesome. I'm gonna have to invest in spells, although I think you can teach your companion spells with the UFO mod. Well, I also thought that they ignore traps with the UFO mod, so I could be wrong. So we have got a few more messages at the water well we have to check when we get back. So some of the best basic mods is glowing ore, which is why this ore is, well, it's glowing. It makes it easier to see, and faster mining. You get everything in 3 hits instead of sitting there in 9 hits. It's, it's like an essential mod, I think. Yeah, faster mining and glowing ore is just... I would never play the game without those two. Come, we do battle. Oh! We're okay. That power attack. Oh, man. All right. I saw that going very poorly for a moment there. The thing is, I don't really want to level up my lockpicking, which will force me to level up my character, and I don't really want to do any level ups with this skill, Fingersmith, which is what it's called in Skyrim Redone. That's why you're not going to really see me mess around with lockpicks that much. I could order my companions to do those things, I guess, if they have a high enough skill. Alright, we're getting close to the end. Hello. Shield bash in the face.
I'll kill you.
And just know that at this point in the game, before, like, this has been tested already, like, off of recording, just, you know, messing around. I can get killed in one hit if I do not block a two-handed power attack by some people. So, like I said, this may seem easy, but I'm very fragile. If I don't block those, I could die in one hit. It's happened before. Many times. When I was leveling up to level 6 before I even started this playthrough. Dude just come out of nowhere, boom, one attack, and I was dead. I'm like, aw, man. Makes me a sad Roman. Oh, I forgot about this part. Alright. And yes, I know about all these fire pots, in case anybody is thinking I'm blind. I know what they do, I just choose not to use them right now. Oh, shit. Shoot me in the face, will ya? Could you, like, random thought here. Could you imagine Mountain Blade looking like this? How awesome that would be? Man, what if Bannerlord looks like this? I mean, even this game is, you know, a couple years old in tech and didn't look, like, the best when it first came out. But still looks pretty good, I think. And man, yeah, Mountain Blade, full invasion mod with these graphics. Oh, man. Oh, that'd be so cool. Okay, so do I remember this combination by heart? Oh, man, I think I'm missing one. I got to check it. Damn it. I used to know all of these, but now I don't remember. Bear, butterfly, owl. That's right, you just have to do them all twice. Yep. Yep. Damn it. oh well. Onward, troops. You're almost there. Now, before I ever used glowing ore, I never knew this ore was over here. Never knew until I used that mod. Because I always just passed it up. I never looked this direction. Ah, faster mining is awesome.
Would you look at that?
Yep, Findle. That was actually my reaction when I first played this game when it came out the first time. When coming in here, I was like, holy shit. It's like, what the hell is this? This giant rock thing. And then the music. And I was like, whoa, what the hell's going on with my screen? This game is so cool. Now boss fight. Do my shouts. Go back to sleep, Overlord. He didn't even get to shout. Alright, maybe having two companions in this part was pretty easy. There you are. Oh. There we go. Alright, I think there are two more chests. Here's one of them, and this has the tablet, I think, right? No. Did I already get the tablet? Ah, there it is, Dragonstone. Eh, you can keep your axe, I don't want it. Alright, now we can leave. Whoa, that's trippy in third person. Now, I always was curious what this was. I could never find like a book or anything that would explain why there's this skull with the flowers right here. Like, I never knew. If anyone knows the lore behind this pedestal, if there is even any, let me know, because I've never been able to find it. But I've always been curious. I'm like, who was this supposed to be in this game? Alright, so I think that's going to bring this episode to a close. We have conquered the Bleak Falls Barrow, and my companions are down there. Okay, good. I thought they were gone. So thanks for watching, everybody, and I will see you in the next adventures in Skyrim. Take care.